Hello students, we'll go with the problems on RK method for simultaneous equations. The question is solve dy by dx equals to 1 plus zx, dz by dx plus xy is equals to 0, y of 0 is equals to 0, z of 0 is equals to 1 at x equals to 0.3 by applying fourth order Runge-Kutta method. Now, if you see in the question, we are having two simultaneous equations. Okay. So, write one side to other. Write dy by dx equals to 1 plus zx, dz by dx plus xy is equals to 0. This is already dy by dx equals to. So, write this as it is. Here, I have to make dz by dx equals to. So, shift this xy this side. So, it will become minus xy. From the given, we are having y of 0 is equals to 0. Z of 0 is equals to 1. What does this mean is? This means x naught is 0, y naught is 0. X naught is 0, z naught is 1. Here in both the conditions, x naught has to be same. If it is not, means the condition given is wrong. Okay, x naught is 0, y naught is 0 and z naught is 1. X1 is 0.3. What value we are computing, that will be your x1. X1 is 0.3. You are required with h in the formula. Have they given you h? No. How to compute h? H is computed as x1 minus x0. So 0.3 minus 0 is how much? 0.3. So h is 0.3. Okay. Whatever we are having, this two simultaneous equation, represent dy by dx as f of xyz. Because if you see in this expression, you are having y, you are having z and you are having x. So, represent this function as f of x, y, z. If this expression is containing only x and y, denote it as f of x, y. Okay, depending upon c to the equation and write. So, this is f of x, y, z. The second expression, you denote it as g of x, y, z. That is minus x, y. We need to compute y of 0.3 and z of 0.3. Okay. So, to start, I will be computing for k1 L1, k2 L2, k3 L3 and k4 L4. So, we will start with to compute k1. What is k1 formula? It is h into f of x0, y0, z0. H is how much? 0.3. F as it is. x0 is 0, y0 is 0 and z0 is 1. We need to compute this. So, to compute f of, consider this f of x, y, z function. So, f of x, y, z is equals to 1 plus z, x. So, x is 0, y is 0, z is 1. So, substitute over here. 1 as it is, z is 1, x is 0. Simplifying, you will get 1. So, when we substitute 1, we will get k1. The very next step after k1, we are going to compute for L1, not k2. Okay? Because in the k2 formula, we are required with L1. So, what is L1 given by? H into g of x0, y0, z0. H is how much? 0.3. G of x0 is 0, y0 is 0, z0 is 1. Now, your clue is when you are computing k1 and L1, whatever bracket values are there after simplified, f of, okay, the same value will be over here. Okay, just a clue to remember. So, you need not go to simplify. Directly, you can write this values only over here. Now, I need to compute g of 0, 0, 1. I want g of, so consider g of x, y, z function. This is what this. What it is given by? Minus x, y. So, g of 0, 0, 1 is equals to x is 0, y is 0. Okay, so 0 into 0 is 0. So, 0.3 into 0 is 0. So, L1 is 0. Next, we'll compute for K2. K2 is h into f of x0 plus h by 2, comma y0 plus k1 by 2, comma z0 plus l1 by 2. H is 0.3, f as it is. X0 is how much? 0 plus h is 0.3 by 2. Y0 is 0. k1 is 0.3 upon 2. Here I have got. Z0 is 1. L1 is 0 upon 2. 0.3 upon 2 it is 0.15 plus 0 is 0.15. 0.3 divided by 2 is 0.15 plus 0 is 0.15. 0 divided by 2 is 0, 1 remains. I need to compute f of 0.15, 0.15, 1. So, consider f of x, y, z. that is f of 0.15 comma 0.15 comma 1 if you have to compute, 1 will remain as it is, z value is 1, x value is 0.15. Substitute, simplify, you will get your f of this value. Multiply that answer with 0.3. So when you multiply the equation value, then you will get the answer as 0.0345. This is your k2 value. Similarly, we are going to compute for L2. What is L2? H into g of x0 plus h by 2 comma y0 plus k1 by 2 comma z0 plus L1 by 2. Now this I have computed. Here I have substituted all the values. You need not have to do these all things. Directly you can write this step. On what basis? On what we have got k2. K2 f of what you have got? No, only f must be changed as g. That is only the difference. Okay. Then compute for g of this by taking this expression. That will be your L2. Similarly, k3. K3 is h into f of x0 plus h by 2 comma y0 plus k2 by 2 comma z0 plus L2 by 2. X0 is 0, h is 0.3 divided by 2, y0 is 0, k2 is 0.345 upon 2 comma z0 is 1, L2 is minus 0.0067 upon 2. When we simplify this, okay, we will get here 0.15, 0.1725, 0.996. This value we need to compute by taking f of. Simplifying, multiplying with 0.3, you will get k3. When you are computing for L3, the change is only what? Same formula, h into g of it will come and this all quantity will remain same. So directly you can write this here. Okay, so g of. Now multiply, you will get your L3. Similarly, k4, h into f of x0 plus h, comma y0 plus k3, comma z0 plus L3. So 0.3 f of 0 plus 0.3, 0 plus 0.3448 from the above what we have got here. Next, 1 plus minus of 0.00776. Simplify, that will be f of. We can compute f of from here. Multiplying, that will be your k4. So now we are going to compute for L4. What is the change here? H of g of it will come directly 0.3 into g of 0.3 and this quantity. Substituting in g of, simplifying, you will get your g of, multiply it with 0.3, you will get L4. Therefore, the required solution will become y of x1 is equals to y of x0 plus h, that is y0 plus 1 by 6 into k1 plus 2 k2 plus 2 k3 plus k4. Substitute the values, x0 is 0, h is 0.3, y0 is 0, 1 by 6, k1 plus 2 times k2 plus 2 times k3 plus k4. That will be a y of 0.3. Similarly, when we are computing for z of x1, that is z of x0 plus h, it will become z0 plus 1 by 6, L1 plus 2 L2 plus 2 L3 plus L4. Substituting the values, simplifying, that will be z of 0.3. This way we are computing for simultaneous equations by RK method. Solution of simultaneous equation by RK method. Thank you.